another update on COVID in Bristol and what we are doing to keep you safe. So Bristol's rate of infection is at 397 cases per 100,000 population. This compares to 415 cases per 100,000 this time last week. So our rates are coming down, but we have been warning that they kind of plateaued. They've been hovering around a little bit. Our highest rate of infection during the pandemic was 889 per 100,000, which we saw during the week of the 12th to the 18th of July. So you can see we're below half, but we're still at a very high level. The England rate stands at 307 cases per 100,000. So we are above that England rate, which is a challenge for us as well. Our overall infection rate has, as I said, has plateaued with daily fluctuations, but our positivity rate remains high, which shows the virus is still circulating widely in Bristol. We have 81 people in our hospitals unwell with COVID at this time. So it's important we continue to work together to engage in COVID-safe behaviours, provide COVID-secure environments to minimise potential of the virus spreading. Wear your face covering, keep your distance, take regular lateral flow tests, wash your hands, meet outdoors if you can, and if you're indoors, keep the spaces ventilated. That way you'll keep yourself safe, but you'll keep those around you safe. Both those you know, your loved ones, and people you don't know who you could be a conduit for virus transmission. On the vaccinations front, up to the 17th of August, 75% of people over the age of 16 had had either their first dose of the vaccine, while 60% of people over 16 have had their second dose. So our numbers are reasonably strong, although they're not hitting the England average rates, which are at 78% for the first doses and 67% for the second doses. Younger adults out and about are the age groups that we've got the biggest, where we've got the biggest vaccination gap. We're also seeing the highest COVID case rates in the under 40s and the 20 to 30s. The COVID-19 vaccine is now available to everyone over the age of 16. If you're between the age of 16 and 17 and 3/4, you can either wait to be contacted by your GP or visit one of the city's walk-in clinics. If you're 17 and 3/4 and over, you can book your vaccine on the NHS website, attend a walk-in clinic, or wait to be contacted by your GP. Not all walk-in clinics are vaccinating people under the age of 18. So visit our website for full details. Last week, a new walk-in vaccination clinic opened in Cabot Circus. On the first weekend, over 550 people received their vaccination. So if you've not had your vaccine yet, it's not too late. And please remember, vaccination is a key tool in our fight against COVID-19, provides the best protection for you, your family, and our city. So from the 11th of November, anyone entering a care home as part of their professional responsibilities will be required to show proof of vaccination or exemption unless they are under the age of 18. This includes care workers, hairdressers, and maintenance staff. A full list can be found in the vaccination of people for the vaccination of people deployed, working or deployed in care homes, operating guidance on gov.uk. This means they'll need to have their first vaccination by the 16th of September. The NHS COVID-19 pass will be used to check and demonstrate vaccination center status. It's important that all those entering care homes, including those who are exempt from vaccination, continue to follow infection prevention and control measures. This includes the correct usage of PPE to reduce the risk of transmissions and protect our vulnerable residents. And as part of this new guidance, we've been writing to all of our affected staff to advise them of these changes and the timescale they will need to follow in getting both doses of the vaccine before the deadline on 11th of November. We have also provided information about how to get the vaccine and support with any questions or concerns they may have. Now, the rules around self-isolation changed on Monday. So people who are double vaccinated or under the age of 18 are no longer legally required to self-isolate if identified as a close contact of a positive COVID-19 case. Rather than self-isolating, you're strongly advised to have a PCR test as soon as possible. Remember, the PCR test is not the same as a lateral flow or rapid test you can use at home. Once you have taken your PCR test as a close contact with no symptoms, you are not required to self-isolate while you wait for the result. However, you are advised to take extra measures like wearing face coverings in enclosed spaces and limiting contact with others, especially the clinically vulnerable. If you do have symptoms and test positive for COVID-19, you must still self-isolate. Okay, so everyone, please stay safe.